So don't mind the camera angle and my hair. But so I ended up yesterday, after I finished the vlog, I ended up kind of like pricing things out and then like posting some of them. Some of them are on bid, some of them, like two items I posted in one area. Well, one of them is a belt. It's a Tory Burch belt. My mom ended up getting it a while back for like $13. And she said, you can sell it because it's a small size. So I put the size, I put like the length of it and everything. Well, within 5 minutes, I've been getting offers. And this is just last night. I've been getting offers like crazy. There was somebody asking for $10 for it. I declined that one right away because I'm like not doing that. And then I woke up this morning. I've been getting like $25, $30, $35 offers from multiple people. And I just kind of let those sit there for a little bit just to see like maybe somebody would buy it for $45. Then I ended up posting it on Facebook, market listing. For 45, and I got a message within like 5 minutes, somebody asking for 35, and I said, unfortunately, like I can't do 35 because on Facebook at least you can reply, like respond to them faster, but Poshmark you can't really do that unless they directly like comment on your thing. But I told them, unfortunately, I can't do that due to a lot of other offers coming in. Right now, my lowest I will go is 45. And then they're like, okay, can we do like 40? And I'm like, sorry again, like I'm getting offers for it. And so I called my mom, I told her about it. And as I'm on the phone with her, the person on Facebook buys it right away. And I'm like, okay. So I sold it. And if you're curious as to what kind of belt it is, like I said, it's a Tory Burch. It's a small size. It doesn't really fit me, but has the logo and everything. So that was good. Like it worked out. I'm like very excited because this is working, and I'm just like, oh, I don't know. But thought I'd update you guys on that. I'm currently getting ready for work. It's 7:48, so I have to get my budding gear and whatnot. I'm gonna take the belt with me. And yeah, so I'm at work, and this is what I wanted to show you guys yesterday. This is a welt. So this leather piece that goes on the top, ooh, like this one, that's a welt that goes on top. So that's what I'm doing. But today my plan is to get these done. I still have another pair to do, but it's a full 360, so it literally goes all the way around. This takes forever to do, so I'll kind of show you. Literally, I have to poke a hole, find the original hole first, poke a hole, then find the original hole in the boot and not go through the rubber, and then hook that, pull it out, and then thread this through the loop that I created. And then pull it. And that's literally all I've been doing yesterday at work. And so I didn't really vlog much. So I might do like a little time lapse. We'll see. But my plan for, as people are calling me, who are you? I don't know you. Yeah, exactly. That was weird. Somebody was calling me, but nope. My plan for today is to get these welts done. Hopefully, I can get both of them done because I have two pairs. This is the first pair, which I'm almost done with, and then the second pair, which is gonna take a lot longer. So then tomorrow, I can work on the weekly company thing that I do. Timer is going off. And so I have that.
that I want to do tomorrow, and then I have a few other projects that I want to start. I could have started them earlier this week, but I literally got those projects in last week, and so I kind of had like one project that I finished already beginning of this week, or no, end of last week, and I already called the lady, and she's like, oh, well, that was fast. Usually we don't, like, we're not super fast with our repairs, because as you can tell, this is taking me forever to do, and so, yeah, there's that, but,
where's the hole?
Yeah, there we go. I think so. But yeah, I want to start my projects again. I still have a big personal project that I'm doing here at the shop, which I haven't really been mentioning at all. That didn't go through. See why it takes so long? Sometimes it doesn't go through, and you can easily rip this thread, which wouldn't be good. So, but I have one personal project that I'm doing here at work, and I want to get back to it, but at the same time, I'm like scared to get back to it because it's kind of a nightmare. The way that I stopped working on it, it was not going too hot, so there's that. But yeah, I just wanted to kind of chat with you guys.
Yesterday's vlog was about 20 minutes long, which wasn't too bad, so my computer actually let me uploaded on time this morning. I just had to add like the thumbnail, the description, and whatnot, and it was good to go.
So I have that set up already, and yeah, this is how we do it. But after I'm done with this, my mom and I are actually gonna go to a few stores just to see what kind of stuff they sell. So I literally told her, I'm like, if you find anything like Tory Burch, like grab it from like one of like the thrift stores, because that belt sold fast. Like I said, I told you guys, I put it up for sale last night around 11:30. I got offers, but those offers weren't too great. I mean, I had somebody offer like 10 bucks for the belt, and I'm like, hit no. It's a pretty expensive belt, so I'm not going to sell it to somebody for 10 bucks. And technically, I won't be making any profits if I end up selling it for 10 bucks, because my mom said she bought it for 13. So, why are you... Okay. Are you done? Okay. And, so I actually sold it for the price that I put it up for. I have it in my bag. Definitely have to gonna do that today. But my issue is Facebook won't let me put in my bank information. Like, I put it in, but like the button that you press to like move on to the next page does not work. So I brought my computer so I can try it on there. So I'm probably gonna do that after I'm done with these pair of boots here. Excuse me. And hopefully it works on my computer. It's very weird. It might be also that I went to a different window or something, and that's why it didn't work, but we'll see. We will see. And then I have to ship it out and get all of it packed up and ready to go. And so I ended up purchasing a box. It was like Amazon packages and whatnot. Well, what I didn't notice is apparently it's coming from like China, literally all the way. I thought it was coming from like Amazon themselves. So I'm a little bit worried. I really hope I don't get ripped off, because it's kind of scary. Like, I paid about 60 bucks for it, and it was on sale, but the thing is, like, it's still money, like, so it worries me a little bit, because I don't know what to expect because they're literally like a mystery box of unclaimed packages from Amazon. And there's some people that, like, they'll do that on Facebook and they'll do like a mystery package, but most of them are such a ripoff because you just get like dollar store items. If you literally pay for a $40 package, you get like dollar store items, and it's literally not worth it. And so it's like, that's what I'm kind of scared of, and hopefully it comes soon. I didn't pay for shipping, surprisingly, but hopefully I don't have to like pay for any fees. And that's kind of my also main worry. I don't think so, because I don't know, but still, it's kind of scary because I guess it was next door. It's still kind of scary because it's like, I literally don't know what to expect. I paid for it. They told me you'll get like one electronic in there that's worth like a good amount of money. So that's what I'm hoping for. And the rest, I don't know. I don't know what I'm getting. And it's a huge box, apparently, hopefully. It's a huge box. But, we'll see, like, it's still, like, there's some people you can't really trust with when it comes to buying online or anything, so if it's worth it, and I can get at least two items that, like, cover the cost of the, how much I paid for the box, that's already, like, money is worth it, but if it can barely cover my payment that I paid $60 for it, then it's not worth it at all. So we'll kind of see as it comes. It says that it's been processed and is getting shipped now. So hopefully it gets here soon. That'll be great if it does, and hopefully it doesn't take over a month for it to come, because that would not be fun to wait a month and then be disappointed in what I got. So that's what worries me mostly. And even then, like, selling online, I understand customers. It's very iffy to buy things online, especially if it's like from people personally, because so many people get ripped off. And I told you about the scammer who literally wanted to send me a check. Like, you can't trust people whatsoever. It just, it's not worth it. Well, it's like, you can't, not worth it, but like, you can't trust them. And you never know if you're getting ripped off or not. And it sucks. Like, it literally sucks. And so I hope people realize that I'm not, there's some people that are not trying to rip them off at all. They're just trying to make money for a living, like I am doing. But I'm actually almost done with this, surprisingly. I thought it'd take a little bit longer. This is, actually, since this is the last hole, I'm going to go in from here. Come on. There we go. And then that hole I created, where though? There we go. I'm gonna pull this thread in instead, since that is the last hole I have to deal with. There we go. I wear gloves because this string literally cuts into your hands, and so I've had to start wearing the gloves because my hands are literally getting sore from doing this. So I'm going to cut it with my scissors. I'm going to cut up to here. So that can be thrown away. This can be put here. And I'm gonna double knot it. But yeah, this is a welt. This is what I've been doing ever since I got to work, except for minus eating breakfast. I always do that. And here's that. Then I'm actually just gonna leave those like so, and I'm gonna cut like a good amount off so that my brother has enough room to work with, and if he needs to, he can cut it shorter. But it's better to be safe than sorry. And then trying to get this off is a pain in the butt. But I should have flattened this out. Oh gosh. It's okay. He can. It's on there. The thing is, I forgot to push it back so that it looks like this. But I think my brother will be able to do it. Or maybe me. Eh. Nope. He has more muscle strength than I do, so he's gonna deal with that. And now for the big boys, which are these, the 360 welts. I do have to clean out the old stitching that was in there from the previous welt, so I'm gonna do that, and then I will get on to it. So I will update you guys a little bit later on, but I hope you guys enjoyed my little talk. Since I don't do that as often. Home, I'm out of breath because I had to bring a lot of stuff back. I accidentally pressed the stop record button, but that pile where the child is, all this, I pressed it again, but that pile there, I had to bring up. It's a bunch of shoes that need to be cleaned and put to sell online. So I didn't need to do that, but before, then I want to write a script for one of my videos and record a voiceover for it. So hopefully I can do that. And I need to get my budding gear and start cleaning those shoes. And probably tomorrow I'm going to be posting them, but I am exhausted. Like, oh my gosh. And yeah, I'm going to be pretty much spending most of the time cleaning and on my phone trying to get those shoes uploaded. So it should be fun. The baby. But I gotta get back to work, so I'll talk to you later. Thumbnail, as always. Plans kind of changed. I ended up going and helping my roommate. She needed help painting her cafe. So I went and did that, and we bought some Texas Roadhouse, so we're gonna eat. But it's like, it's 9 o'clock and I need to edit this vlog, so I'm gonna end it here. Hopefully it's long enough, but thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Bye. Still working on the thumbnail, you know.